last week, the Denver Broncos announced that former Broncos head coach and NFL legend Mike Shanahan is the newest member elected to the Denver Broncos Ring of Fame. Hello, everyone, and welcome back for another edition of Broncos Beat. I'm Alexis Perry, and joining me today to relive some of Shanahan's best moments over his 20-year career here in Denver, we have James Palmer from the NFL Network, Cecil Lammey from 104.3 The Fan, and longtime Denver sportscaster and friend of Coach Shanahan, Les Shapiro. Well, like you know, Mike Shanahan led the Broncos to 9 winning seasons, 7 postseason appearances, 3 conference championships, and a pair of back-to-back Super Bowl wins. But that was just a fraction of what he was able to accomplish during his time here in Denver. You guys, what was your initial reaction when you heard the news that Mike Shanahan will be the 34th member of the Denver Broncos Ring of Fame?
Well, about time, right? It was inevitable. Look, Mike took them to their first Super Bowl victory, their first 2 Super Bowl victories, and you knew he was going to get in. I think the delay was the Broncos wanted to make sure he was done coaching so that he didn't end up maybe with the San Diego Chargers or the LA Chargers and then come back with the Chargers on the day they were honoring him for the Ring of Fame. So we knew it was going to happen. A few people needed to go in before him, and he's here. It was inevitable.
I loved it because when you think about the Denver Broncos, you think of Mike Shanahan. I mean, point blank, because that offense, that Shanahan-Kubiak system, is the only offense that's won a Super Bowl for this team. You know, because we saw it with, of course, Super Bowl 50. And we saw it with Super Bowl 32 and Super Bowl 33. Mike Shanahan is the Denver Broncos. So I was elated. I was over the moon and just remembering all the times, the great times that Mike Shanahan had with this team. I think it's past time, it was due, and the Broncos did it. So I was very happy.
Yeah, I haven't lived here as long as Les and Cease has, and I was like, wait a minute, he's not in yet? Like, what? I had to go back and look at the list and be like, all right, I thought he was already in. I just assumed it because of what those guys just said, what he means to this organization. And I think Cecil made a great point by saying Super Bowl 50 because of the way Gary Kubiak runs the offense from that Mike Shanahan system. It's almost fitting, right, that that's the offense that wins them their third Super Bowl in a sense. So I think seeing the way – he was also welcomed when he was on the field. Remember, guys, when he was there at training camp and just the herd of people just around him once he left the field and him watching practice at Dove Valley just shows you how important he is to the organization and how much he still is revered. And everybody wanted to get a question into him afterwards just because everybody wants his opinion on everything because that's how highly they respect him.
Yeah, from his very first win to that, you know, winning streak between 1996 and 1998 at home, there were so many memorable moments with Mike Shanahan at the helm. Are there any games or particular moments that really stand out to you guys?
Well, what stands out to me, Alexis, is something you just touched on. When Mike was the coach for those 14 years, you went into every season thinking the Broncos were a playoff contender. And most of those seasons, you thought the Broncos were a Super Bowl contender. Didn't matter who was a quarterback, didn't matter who was a running back. He went through a lot of defensive coordinators, didn't matter what the names were. Mike brought a culture, and Mike brought an attention to detail. Mike brought a focus that allowed Broncos fans to think they had a chance every single year. You didn't get that under Reeves. You certainly didn't get that under any other coach, but you did get that under Mike. There was always hope with Mike Shanahan as head coach of the Broncos.
It's about discipline, right? And if we go to a specific game, I'm going to think when Terrell Davis couldn't see in the Super Bowl due to a migraine, and Mike Shanahan knew that the Green Bay Packers in Super Bowl 32 were not going to bite on the play fake unless Terrell Davis was back in there. And he's like, just go in there. We got to have you in there. I mean, just that one play, you think of the great Broncos victory in that first Super Bowl. And of course, this one's for John. And the relationship, of course, with Mike Shanahan and Mr. Bowlen was outstanding. But I think of the discipline. I've heard Les talk about that plenty over the years, where Mike Shanahan was so disciplined and regimented in what he did. That's why everybody wants to listen. He's like E.F. Hutton for all of us old guys that remember that. Sorry, James, but you know, when Mike Shanahan talks, people listen.
And I like that Cecil brought up Terrell Davis, because the thing that stands out to me is the way he was able to find running backs lower in the draft and they go out and they succeed. That's mostly because of his system. Let's not take anything away from TD or any other running backs with their talent. It's what he developed in terms of how this offense ran, that if you looked at just one running back goes down, he gets up another guy, and it's not a high draft pick, comes out and rushes for 1,000 yards. I think the ability to continue and maintain success running the football, which this is based around, comes from guys that are found all over the map in the draft, and I think that's something that can't be forgotten.
Well, and James, to take that one step further, he had to convince John Elway that that was the way to win. John Elway, who for 14 years previous to that had put this team on his back and almost single-handedly, offensively at least, taken it to the Super Bowl, he had to convince John that the running game was going to get us that trophy. And when he finally convinced John of that and he found Terrell Davis, two Lombardis.
Right, and we think of running game, well, that also ties in hands with the defense. And I'll go to Super Bowl 50 again. Peyton Manning had to be convinced. Of course, his body was, you know, not the same at the time, but it was really that defense and the dash of the running game, of course, that helped lead him to another championship. And we're in kind of an era where people will actually say running backs don't matter. No, it's just the opposite with Mike Shanahan and that system. Running backs do matter. You need that great ground game to help out your defense and also to set up your passing game.
I have to say one stat, Alexis. I know I'm interrupting, but this You're blows good. My mind. Over the last 25 years, only six times has a guy gone over 1,400 yards that was drafted in the fifth round or later. Five of those six were under the tutelage of Mike Shanahan. The sixth guy, Arian Foster down in Houston, and that was Gary Kubiak from the Mike Shanahan system.
Les, you kind of touched on it a little bit with John Elway. Can you put into perspective just how important that relationship is when looking at the history of the Denver Broncos sure. and all of these great moments?
Well, extremely important, because we know that John Elway butted heads with Dan Reeves quite often. Dan Reeves had a system. Dan Reeves wanted the players to play within that system. What Mike did was he came in and he played to John's skill set. And even when Mike was an assistant under Dan Reeves, he had to act as a buffer and explain to Dan, listen, we need to use him in this way. And Dan did listen sometimes. I think it led to some of their success. But once Mike had him alone without Dan Reeves, and Mike was allowed to play to the system that was necessary with John's skill set, that's when John had his best statistical years. And that's when the franchise and John and Mike had their best success.
It was listening. It was that confidant that you could rely on, that John Elway could go to and say, hey, this is what I like. This is what I saw. And then you saw the versatility from Mike Shanahan, essentially taking what Bill Walsh did with the 49ers and improving on that, you know, kind of tweaking it a little bit. And then, like Les said, making it custom fit for the talent that you had on the team.
Well, I know that we could sit here all day and talk about the impact that Mike Shanahan has had on the Denver Broncos, but his influence that he's had on the NFL as a whole cannot be ignored. We will talk about how Shanahan has changed the game coming up on the other side of the break.